replacement for the current FPL facility. I met with Jim Galloway and the airport authority chairman Jeff Sykes. And their question was, how can they get their $2 million early? And they can afford it to start. And there is no way there, I mean, from us, they have the ability to borrow funds if they want to. They asked about a bond, the amount of money here, and the cost of doing bond, I think we did it. And I told them, I did tell them that time it would still be based on the percentage of funding we receive from SWAT. You note that this was in the 100% budget earlier. But at the time I discussed this with them, I had a lot of my conversation. I say, we still have to receive the money. So I'm not sure, and they were not sure. They were along that, so you may have already heard of that, from the team back to you.
Okay.
They asked for 2.9. I asked what the floor plan, what square footage was. They don't know. They really don't have a design, a floor plan. They did not reveal that. The main thing is that the separation of the control tower from this structure. This plan is to build a structure in front of the existing and then demo the current building. Now the tower is in funding for the TIF project, but that is 4 years away. They're not going to be demoing this building with that being part of it until that funding is available.
I know at one point they were initially talking about the tower would be an independent structure from the FPO.
That's correct.
And so they had discussed about building the tower, because the real issue is not with the FPO as much as it is the fact that the tower is on the runway right away, basically. So that creates a problem. Light line, because it's built into that building. So the discussions have been for a long time that they would build a new tower out away from the current structure, and then, like you said, come out in front of the FBO now and build a new building and then demo that one.
If you stand in front, directly in front of the current structure, off to your right is an old oak. Jeff and Jim told me that that is the location they have for the plan for the tower. But as far as the timeline on the funding of that, I don't know. Does this answer your question?
Pretty much, huh? So it's going to be built to get to the east end. And so the goal is to demo the old one down all the way?
Yeah, they need to demo it because of having the line of sight they need from that tower for that runway area.
And if we expand the airport, I guess this would be in line with that future plan?
Yeah, I think.
This is
on
the general aviation.
This is general aviation. The FBO is the private pilot side.
That's a big space operator.
Yeah, they don't have anything, no request for that here. What we know is the commercial airport. Okay. They don't have any request for that. This is all.
That was my question. Not that I'm opposed to it at all, but why do FBO altogether? I mean, what benefit does that bring? I mean, I know other than the obvious, we is it in such batch? I've only been in there once or twice in recent years.
I mean, this, I don't know when it was built, my guess is it was in the
Sixties.
I would think, fifties, but I don't.
So they're also under a situation where the location is grandfathered in, because it's so close to the runway, and that's kind of an issue, I think it's.
It's a safety issue more than it is cosmetic utilization. Now, they will be able to receive grant, as they do already, for the ground school, I'm not sure what other businesses they have in there, but I think they have one or two that.
They did have that, their traffic control, classes in school, was there, so.
Well, yeah, this has got nothing to do with what the public sees as far as, I mean, not that it's not open to the public, well, it's really not.
Well, it's open to the public from the standpoint of private, private coming in and out.
You have a private plane that it's open.
You have a plane, you don't really get to see.
You have planes, though. If you look on the page, you're a little concerned with the problem. The question concerning the goal is this a short-term or a long-term goal?
I'd say longer.
Long-term.
Because funding for the tower is coming from somewhere else, right? So if they're not going to do that in 4 years, then this is a 5 or 6 year project.
You agree?
Yeah.
Questions?
Well, my hesitation just comes from the fact of not knowing exactly what the timeline is on the tower, and what the overall timeline is. I would certainly think it's not something that's going to probably happen in the 2021 budget cycle.
So, if it, can we say that if the project is beyond this upcoming budget?
Correct.
It is a long-term.
Long-term program, that's correct.
So to define long-term, yeah. Mark, do you agree? Scott? And it does have an impact on our future growth, in my opinion, as far as that's concerned. And the only, the impact concerning the budget simply be from a SPOS plan, not from models.
Nothing.
You recall, I think, when Jim came before y'all, he presented you some information concerning this SPOS mission. Another topic from Commissioner Marshall was the broadband.